Hello everyone, today we are going to see the problems in open circuit. I have discussed about the open circuit in last video. If you want to know about these things, just go through the last video and then come for the problem, then it will be very easier to you to understand. Now first problem, find VAB in the circuit shown. This is the circuit which is given to you. They are asking you to find VAB, which means you have to find the voltage across the terminal A and B in the circuit. Now you have to find whether this terminal is open or closed. Here this A and B terminal is open, so you should be very clear in that. If the circuit is open, there will not be any flow of current in the circuit. So throughout the circuit there is no flow of current. So I have just redrawn the circuit to understand it more clear. Just I have drawn I, which is equal to 0 in the circuit. So if current I is equal to 0, then there is no flow of current. So there is no flow of current across the 10 ohm resistor also. So the voltage across the 10 ohm resistor is 0 when I is equal to 0. You know very well V is equal to I into R. So here the current is 0. So the voltage across the 10 ohm resistor is 0. Then you have to find out the voltage across the terminal A and B. Now you apply the rule KVL. You just take, usually I am taking from potential drop to rise. So I am taking this is positive and we are traveling in the same direction like clockwise. So I am taking 10 volt. So this will be an potential drop. So negative VAB, then negative sign 10 into I. I is 0 equal to 0. If you simplify this, then you are getting voltage across the terminal AB is 10 volt. Similarly, we are going to see the another problem. Here also you have to find the voltage across the terminal A and B. So just I have taken current I, and here it is a node which is separating into two branches. So I am, this current is flowing in clockwise direction, and when it is meeting a node, it is just going into two branches. So I am just taking this branch as I1 and this branch as I2. If you look here, this port A and B means this terminal A and B is open. So there will not be any flow of current in this branch. So I am writing I2 is equal to 0. So the current which is flowing through this loop is same. So here I is equal to I1. Now you apply the KVL for this loop. Once you find the KVL, means once you write the KVL, you can you will be able to find the current value I. Once you find the current, then you have to find out the voltage across the 5 ohm resistor, because you have to find the voltage across the terminal A and B. If you want to find, means if you want to find out the voltage across the terminal A and B, you have to find the voltage across the resistor 5 ohm which is parallel to this two terminal. So whatever you know very well, this voltage, the voltage across the elements which is connected in parallel is same. So if you find out the voltage across the 5 ohm, then it is same as the voltage across the terminal A and B. Now you just apply the KVL for this. So usually I used to take this is from negative to positive. I am taking this as a potential rise, then this will be the potential drop. So negative 5 into I. So this is also a potential drop, minus 5i which is equal to 0. Then you just simplify this then and find out the I. I is equal to 1 ampere, which is equal to I1. Now you have to find out the voltage across this 5 ohm resistor For this you have to apply the voltage divider rule. I have written the voltage divider rule formula. I am taking this as R1, this as R2. So R1 is 5 ohm, R2 is 5 ohm, voltage is 10 ohm. Just you substitute this value, then voltage across the 5 ohm resistor, which is R2, is 5 volt, which is equal to the voltage across the terminal A and B. In this problem, luckily you have got R1 and R2, both are same. So here you will be getting the same answer for V1 and V2. But if you are having different resistors, then you will get a different answer. So you should be very clear about the voltage divider rule and the current divider rule. Third problem, find the current I when the switch is opened. This is your circuit. So this is a switch. They are asking you to find out the current I when the switch is open. When this is open, you have to find out what is the current. You know very well, when the switch is open, there will not be any flow of current in this branch. So this current is just meeting this point and it is diverting into two branches. You can take this as one I1 or this as I2, where this I2 is 0. So this I is same as I1. So you have to find out the KVL for this loop and find what is I. Very simple. So first, I have, just for your understanding, I have drawn two circuits, which is having closed switch and another one is open switch. But you have to find out when the switch is open, you have to find out the current when the switch is open. So this is closed switch. If it is closed, then you have to find out two branch current, I1 and I2. For this, you no need to find. Here you have to find only what is I1, which is equal to I. So just you apply KVL. So 50 minus 10i minus 10i equal to 0. Then I is equal to 2.5 ampere. Just you simplify this, you will be getting the answer. So we will be moving to next topic. If you have any doubts in these problems, you can do comment. We will meet in next video. Thank you.